We'll start with an update on Tropical Storm Debby this morning. As the system becomes better organized in the southeastern Gulf, you can see that the convection increasing, trying to wrap around and form a center of the storm, but not there just yet. Some of the outer bands are already working into southwestern Florida, and as this moves over the warm Gulf waters and encounters atmosphere with little wind shear, Tropical Storm Debby is expected to become a Category 1 hurricane before making landfall tomorrow afternoon in the Big Bend region of Florida. At that point, max sustained winds will be around 75 miles per hour. Of course, flooding rains and intense wind for the state of Florida, and then even as this pushes up toward Georgia and the Carolinas by midweek, it will not have direct impact on our forecast here in Alabama, but it will have influence because that's how the atmosphere works. All of this is piecing together. You can see we're on the drier side of the storm, the west side. There could be a few showers and even some cloud cover over East Alabama tomorrow, but we don't anticipate much from the system. And the reasoning is because this counterclockwise flow promotes more of a north wind into Alabama, and that means drier air for us. Just a rule of thumb, if we're on the western side, typically that means dry weather for us. So this system may stall between Georgia and the Carolinas, some models indicating it hanging around for a little while next week, and I do think that's a possibility. Well, at the same time, we have high pressure building in from the west, and not to say that these two are going to battle, but I do think high pressure rules our forecast. Now, cloud cover, a little bit of moisture swing this way, sure, but we're not anticipating any significant rainfall here across Alabama. We'll go through the 7-day forecast. It's pretty quiet here at home, but we will see a lot of heat next week, and so that's going to be the big headline for us here. This afternoon, feeling more like the triple digits across many spots, especially to the west, but we remain below heat advisory criteria. Maybe a few showers possible. Most of those will be south of Interstate 20, and we don't anticipate much rain. Tomorrow, similar story. I do think there will be a bit more cloud cover in East Alabama, keeping some of you a little bit cooler as this system works into Georgia and moves up toward the East Coast. A few showers possible tomorrow afternoon. Wouldn't anticipate much rain. Look at those numbers by the middle of the week, 95 on Tuesday, 97 Wednesday, pretty close to triple digit heat with a drier air mass in place as high pressure tries to build in from the west. Hopefully by the weekend, we're a little cooler, but it's going to be a scorcher getting those kids back to school.